Bratmail Mixtape by Cash Doll. Arkesha Knight was born in Detroit, Michigan. She always had a love for writing poetry and wanted to be a rapper, but she didn't think it was obtainable. After high school, she became a stripper and made enough to pursue her career as an artist. She credits Aaliyah, J-Lo, Fabolous, Rick Ross, Drake, and others for her inspiration to rap. Bratmail is a collection of songs Cash teased on her social media and released for her fans on her birthday. How do we feel about Bratmail by Cash Doll?
Bratmail by Cash Doll, man. Yo, when I first put it on, and you know, she started out with the intro, which was the same verse she did from the BET Cypher, I was just like, I'm glad she did that, because it was just to let people know that she can rap for real before she went into dancing. Because when dancing came on, I initially wanted to throw my phone immediately. And I'll tell you what it was, because she's like, fast car, vroom, vroom, yeah. Big gun,
yeah.
Boom, boom.
Yeah.
Like, nigga, when she said boom, boom, because I was like, she better not say boom, boom. Like, I was saying it in my head, like, don't say boom, boom, and she said boom, boom. But I want to say on I Want featuring Skrilla, I actually thought she kind of brought it back. I actually thought Skrilla did a cool thing where on there. Dividends, I wasn't really feeling the hook, but I liked the way she flowed on that. Fastest route was cool. Check was cool. Real Talk was another one of those joints. I think it was okay. Serious, I liked the fact that, you know, she wanted to show that she could. But I felt like it was too short, you know. And it's just a skit to go out. You know, I mean, it's a pretty short and sweet joint. Overall, I wasn't overly impressed. I do like the fact that she showed that she can rap. She can spit when she wants to. But I feel like she was trying to also cater to the sound of now. And I'm pretty sure a lot of these songs would play in the club. I feel like the mix on some of the songs is kind of bad, especially for her to be such an established artist. And I get this joint a C-. I think it was average.
What? Bro, what are you talking about, man?
Yeah, man.
It's funny, it's like you say that and then shout out to Cash Doll, like, but not trying to be funny, like, dead serious,
right, yeah.
But people think you're trying to be funny.
Well, you know, I don't want to sound like an overly hater, but it's just like, the sound of this was just like, you know, the I get money talk, braggadocious, you know, if you ain't getting money, this and this and that. Typically, that's not the type of music I like to rock with, but putting that all aside, you know, she does have a great rap, I would say, cadence, because, you know, she's always attacking the track, you know, she's always confident. She sounds hella confident. But like you said, you know, it reminded us of how she could rap with a certain note with the intro. But when they went to dance and that one two word pop flow, I can't really dig with that, especially when it's something simple, like you said, vroom vroom and everything like that. But when it went to I Want, I was like, okay, she's starting to show that she has some type of content that she can stay consistent with and not just, you know, bore you or whatever. Dividends just seems like the standard clap club track and everything like that. Fastest route, I thought she was about to kill it because she was just like, you know, let me show y'all how we rap, how you get on the track. She really didn't kill it for me. It was like a minute where she just flowed.
Yeah.
I don't really think she killed it on that. Check was more, I could say, better representation of like the artist that she's trying to be. I can see that like going, make the rounds of radios a lot and everything like that. Rich Talk was cool. Serious, I liked it because it was a different sound compared to all the other tracks on the mixtape to show how she can go another route. But overall, I just really thought that, you know, with all the simple braggadocious talk, it kind of put her in a box, and I never really got to see what more she can do. You know, from the cipher that she had, you know, it kind of wanted me more of that route. I'm not just saying I want to hear more lyricism or nothing like that, but I just want to hear a little bit more than the offer to this, because I feel like you can hear this type of music from any kind of artist, really. So that note, I gave it a D+. I thought it needed work.
No.
I feel like she has, you know, the aura of the, like, that needs to be of an artist like this, but try to broaden your horizons just a little bit more.
Yeah, man. Yeah.
All right.
Nah, but seriously though, on some real shit though, Cash Doll, I do think she's pretty dope. I just feel like, you know, like I said, she's just catering to the sound of now, and that'll work for some things.
It'll work, but you know, if you want to have some longevity, you need to try to, you know, branch.
Yeah, I mean,
over.
She got to kind of have like a couple like kind of like lovey type songs and stuff.
Something
like
that.
Like,
yeah.
You got to spread it out, you know.
Right.
We'll be right back.
Yo, you looking for TV reviews, music reviews, movie reviews? Then check out the only reviews that matter, man.
Yeah, just hit that subscribe button. Make sure you hit the notifications and stay tuned.